Hannah continued to scream as she raced away from Kohapa, all the while crying and trying to figure out what had happened to Dave. Had she imagined it? Was the stress of everything happening on the railway getting to her? She had to find out, looking everywhere for her boyfriend, as she frantically raced around, searching every siding and location on the line, calling his name. Eventually, having checked everywhere, she arrived at Mirkum in a frenzy, seeing that Dave was nowhere to be seen. Having seen her distress, Theo and Otto, who had been trying to help Clyde at this point, came over to ask what was the matter. Hannah, what's happened?
Dave! He's gone!
Gone? Gone where?
I don't know. I saw him arriving at Kohapa Sheds, but then something happened. He told me a while ago that he thought he was seeing demonic versions of one of his ex-girlfriends, and I thought he was maybe in his head. But I saw her! I saw her appear and she took him! She took Dave, and I don't know where, and I don't know how to get him back.
Calm down, Hannah. You're raving. Does that mean that Leanne has finally managed to escape death again?
It wasn't Leanne. It was another ex, Linda.
Linda? I've never heard of her. He's never spoken to us about her.
He told me about her. He was having nightmares about her while he was unconscious for his overhaul. I think that this has something to do with it. But I don't understand.
What are you saying? That a dream demon has whisked him away? Even by our standards, that's a bit crazy, Hannah. Hannah barely registered this as she fought hard.
Wait, you two do scientific shit, don't you? You did that thing to Clyde. Can't you figure out what happened to him? And if we can find him?
This is kind of beyond our own endeavours, Hannah. I've never heard of an engine being evaporated out of existence by a bad dream. Hannah began to cry even harder as Clyde rolled over.
Hannah, what's happened?
Dave's gone! Dave's gone and it's all your fault!
Now, Hannah. Clyde has been here all this time. It's not his fault. You're being hysterical.
And it's you two's fault!
I hardly think that it is.
You've built things in the past that fucked with reality. Look at Clyde shapeshifting. Look at your gun fixing the viaduct. And didn't you once travel through time and teleport an innocent engine away from the railway?
Perhaps, but we swear, we've got nothing to do with this. We... Hold on a moment. Can you hear that? The engines could hear what sounded like eerie music emanating out of the air, as a thick fog suddenly began to descend on the area.
Oh no. Oh, not this shit again.
Theo, Otto, Hannah and Clyde awoke in a misty place, with nothing around and no rails to speak of. Hannah looked incredibly cross.
Now look what's happened! We've been killed by musical lightning!
No, we haven't.
I don't feel dead.
Is this your doing, Clyde? Did these idiots give you teleporting powers as well or something?
No, not that I'm aware of.
But then, where are...
Something shifted in the mist and came towards them.
You are not dead.
Welcome to my locker. I'm glad to see that you lot have managed to remain alive since my last visit.
Locker? What a stupid name for a paranormal pocket dimension!
Hannah was too cross to completely take in what was happening.
You there! Ghost thing!
Pogo.
Pogo stick! Whatever! Why have you taken my beloved Dave away from us? And why did you send that Linda character to get him?
I didn't take Dave away, and that demon has nothing to do with me. In fact, I was just on my way to the alt to try and rescue him, but I heard your screams and sidestepped into 77C when I realised that you must have seen it happen too.
77C?
Your universe.
And what exactly is Alt? Can I get your autograph?
I'm confused. Are we dead or what?
Pogo sighed.
Let me explain.
When Dave was having his overhaul, his consciousness somehow slipped into the Alt dimension, where demons live.
and feast upon the negative emotions of engines to survive. It is a dimension that I would not like to have to revisit, despite my lack of emotion. I sensed that Dave was there and tried to discover what had happened to him, but by the time I had reached him, he had awoken from his overhaul. Once awake, one particular demon seems to have followed him back to your universe and have been attached to him ever since, feeding on his negativity. Once strong enough, this demon has taken him back to his dimension to continue feeding.
Fascinating! Thanks for the exposition! So why are we hanging around for then? Let's go and rescue him! I can't even be bothered to figure out what's going on anymore. I just want to take action, goddammit!
I can't take all of you with me. Especially you, Hannah.
Why not?
Because of your emotional state. The monsters in the alt would feast upon you.
I'm calm. I'm of a sound state. I can do it. Take me there, you fucking bastard! Now!
I'm afraid I cannot risk your life, Hannah.
Then take Fionotto with you, then. It's their fault to begin with.
I do not appoint blame to anybody. No. I think that the most successful course of action would be to have Clyde accompany me there.
Me? Why me?
Oh no, you're not suggesting you take Clyde to rescue him? After everything he's done recently?
His unusual properties at this current time will be much more useful than the war rage and curiosity that you three feel. Clyde, would you please accompany me on this mission?
I mean, sure, I guess. This is all some sort of dream, right?
No, Clyde. This is a nightmare.
Oh, great! Leave us in this wasteland, why don't you, you bastard? I think I can see why I didn't take you with him. Shut up and find out how we can get out of here!
Clyde awoke in a strange yet familiar place. It looked very much like Woolchurch Station, but everything seemed to be blanketed by thick purple fog. Pogo appeared next to him. I feel that they are holding Dave at what you call Mirkoom Sheds.
Come on then, no time to waste. We've done enough of that recently.
Clyde began to move forwards up the line, but then something appeared in front of him. It looked like a huge diesel.
Clyde.
Aye. Who's asking?
I am. You don't belong here, little steam engine. Why, of course. I can sense your fear. Your anxiety. At being discovered by the British Rail. And take it away from your friend.
Cut the crap, Diesel. I got a friend to rescue.
But you are too late. He is already but a shell of his former self. My colleague has seen to that.
Aye. You're lying.
What possible reason would I have to lie?
No. It can't be deed. Everyone's relying on me to rescue him.
And what will they think of you if you were to return without him? They will shun you. They will disown you and inform British Rail of your true whereabouts.
No! No!
Easier to stay here. And let him feed.
Clyde, don't listen to it. Think good thoughts. Dave is still alive. I can sense it. If we're quick, we will be able to save him. You have friends back home who are relying on you to keep your emotions in check and return safely. Come on. But Clyde was far too terrified of what the diesel was implying to concentrate. And suddenly, through this lack of concentration, he changed back into his original diesel form without thinking about it. The demon recoiled.
What is this witchcraft? What have you done? What are you?
The shapeshifting.
Clyde, confuse it. Confuse the demon.
I can't. I...
Come on, change shape. Think of something bigger and stronger than Howard. You can beat him. Do it!
Clyde did. He thought of a photograph of a very large engine he had seen before. And almost in an instant, he had changed into a gigantic American steam locomotive. The diesel demon looked horrified.
What is happening? What is that?
My friends need me. I well rescued Dave. Get out my way!
The demon did. Confused and scared of what it had seen, it disappeared from sight. Clyde, exhausted, changed back into a diesel form. Pogo was impressed.
That's it, Clyde. We can use your abilities to scare the demon away from Dave. Come on, we have a clear aspect.
The two engines charged up the incline toward Mirko. When they arrived, Clyde breathed hard with fear. Dave was on his own in front of the sheds, whilst what looked like an army of Stallion moguls stood in front of him, blocking his way through. He could hear their evil chanting as he and Pogo drifted forwards.
You let me die!
I didn't even know that you had died, Linda! Please, forgive me!
Don't you see? Not only was my death your fault, but everything terrible, everything that has ever gone wrong in your life is all your fault. No! Please! Leanne's multiple deaths, Repulse being banished, Colin, Cameron, Owen's destruction, if you had not been so selfish and foolish, they all may have remained alive and well.
Please forgive me. Please! Please stop this!
At this point, Clyde's nerves were rattled.
There's too many of them!
I can try something!
Pogo rolled forwards and called out.
Demon! Hear my voice!
The demon suddenly turned to face Pogo.
I expunge you! Be one! Condense yourself back into one body!
And what do you think you are doing? No! Stop this!
Whatever Pogo was doing was working. The multiple demons disappeared, leaving only one, the prime demon, in sight.
Clyde!
Clyde knew what to do. He transformed once again into a gigantic American engine and started forwards.
Begone, demon! Lay him alone!
But she laughed.
I know about the pathetic transformation, Clyde, but it is of no use. I'm not frightened of you. If anything, this is a much better way to complete my meal. Won't you help us try to rescue him? Once I'm finished with you, I will feast upon the rest of your friends, starting with your longest ally, Brian. He will make a great
Dave's smokebox was contorted with fear.
Please! Not Brian! Not Raymond! Hannah! Please leave them alone!
But they are already dead. They didn't come here to save you. Let me finish.
Dave began to weep as the demon advanced, but Clyde suddenly had an idea. If he couldn't scare the demon, maybe Dave could. He rolled up alongside, transforming into a standard 4 tank engine. Brian. Dave? It's me. Brian. I'm here. The demon paused as Clyde spoke in Brian's voice. Pogo, watching from the sidelines, suddenly encouraged him.
Yes, Clyde! Bring back Dave's positive emotions! Lift him up, and he can send her back!
Clyde obliged.
You are my best friend, Dave. I'm back home, with everybody else, willing you to fight this bitch and come back. Life wouldn't be the same without you, mate. Fight her! Think about all the good times we've had. Think about when you rescued me.
Dave did. He thought about how happy he had been to meet an engine like Brian, who he could hold a decent conversation with, who was one of his best friends. They had been there for each other for years, and now he wanted more than ever to do him proud. The demon recoiled in horror as Dave smiled.
Keep going, Clyde. You're doing it.
Clyde changed again, into another familiar friend.
Dave? Raymond! We're all thinking about you right now, Dave. We're willing you on. I want you to remember that, despite being a diesel, I care. Would I have come after you and rescued you from Leanne the first time if I didn't care about you? Would I have helped you out on so many sticky situations if I had not been there as one of your best friends? We've been through a lot together, and there's plenty more good times to be had when you finish her off and come back to us. Go, Dave, go!
The demon form of Linda recoiled even further as good thoughts about his friends flooded back into Dave's mind. Clyde knew one last thing he had to do.
Dave, my love, I am with you in spirit. I am waiting for you to come back. Come back to me, Dave. I love you.
This was all Dave needed to see and hear. With a great effort, the big green engine shouted out,
I love you too, Hannah. I'm going to come back. I've got too much to lose. I don't need to be afraid or scared anymore. You!
He shot an accusatory look at the Linda demon, who was in abject shock.
You are not Linda. You never will be. The Linda I knew would never torment me like this. She was a lot of things, but evil, vindictive and heartless is something she would never be. Get out of my head! Get out of my body! I don't regret anything, and I don't need reminding of the bad times in my past. The future is beautiful! Get out! Get out!
The thing had backed far enough away for Dave to feel normal again. Consumed with the anger of realising what the demon had been doing to him, he charged towards it, screaming.
You will not take me! And you will never take my friends and family away from me again! Dark Railway forever!
As he approached the demon, it suddenly disappeared, screeching as it evaporated. Pogo suddenly rushed in.
Come on, while it is weakened, let's get out of here! I'll use my energy to close off this universe for good. It's no longer attached to you, Dave. Well done, both of you. Now, let's go.
Pogo dragged the two engines out of the universe in a bright flash, leaving the alt quiet and unmoving. Hannah, Theo and Otto were still trying to find a way of leaving the locker when Dave, Pogo and Clyde all appeared. Dave slumped down, clearly exhausted. The real Hannah rushed forward to confront him, and Clyde changed his shape to that of a Caledonian engine once again.
Dave? My love?
Dave groggily spoke up.
Hey Hannah, you're here.
Oh Dave, you okay?
She looked up at Clyde.
Clyde?
Didn't mention it. You look after Dave.
Theo and Otto also came over to see if their friend was alright. While he recuperated, Pogo brought Clyde to one side.
Well done, Clyde. I knew that you could do it.
Thanks. I couldn't let that thing get him.
Indeed. Now, Clyde,
I have finally detected that the reason that you are shapeshifting is that there is an imbalance of tau particles making up your molecular structure.
Aye?
I can take the particles away from you once I send you home, so that you stop shapeshifting once and for all. But you will be trapped in one shape forever once I do this. Now, I can send you back in your original form, or you can select a shape you'd like to remain in. I shall leave the decision up to you for now. When Dave is recovered, I shall send you all home. Have a think, and let me know your decision. Pogo drifted away as Clyde returned to his friends. Once Dave was ready, Pogo prepared them to go home. That dimension is now completely sealed from yours, so you should not encounter those monsters again. Right, thanks, Pogo, for your help in rescuing me. A bit random, but hey-ho.
I will continue to monitor you all from afar. Thank you, whatever you are, for saving him.
Not a problem, Hannah. And here, you two. Here's my calling card. If you ever need me for something, apart from your scientific experiments, use this. Be warned, it better be for a damn good reason, though.
Oh, wow! You signed it!
Hopefully he will never need it.
I hope not, too. I've had enough of science now. The Tau Cannon can stay dead now, for all I care. I just want to go back to shunting.
Everybody laughed, except for Pogo. Be careful, you lot. I will be watching. Goodbye.
Hannah, Dave, Theo, and Otto reappeared outside of Carcass Smash Limited. Terrifying little Buzz, who ran away into the works looking terrified. Dave noticed something, though. Where's Clyde? I hope he didn't. But a few seconds later, an engine materialised nearby. Gone was Clyde the shapeshifter, and gone with Clyde the Class 37. In its place was a handsome looking Caledonian engine.
Clyde?
Aye, it's me.
Can you still shapeshift after all that?
No. Pogo fixed me. I'm no longer Clyde the English Electric Diesel. I am now Clyde the Cali Railway Engine. Permanently.
That's a relief.
Yeah, it really is. But aren't you going to miss being a diesel?
No, not at all. I've always loved steam engines. And besides, I no longer have to fear about being found by British Rail, do I? I feel much more comfortable being in this form, and I hope to make up for my past misdeeds and start afresh.
Well, as you can't change shape anymore, I'm willing to accept your apology.
Same. It's a shame. It could have come in handy.
No, it's more trouble than it's worth, boys. Now, morning, everyone. I bet the other engines are wondering what happened to us.
They'll never believe us.
Doesn't matter. If an engine can shapeshift, they damn well better believe in other dimensions. Morning, everyone. Let's go put their minds at ease and our own. Are you going to be alright after all this, Steve?
Huh? Me? I'll always be fine. I've got my friends, and I've got my home. And that's all I really need.